Good evening, everyone. Welcome back to the channel. My name is Bruno Fightmaster. We're back with some more Pokemon Scarlet and the Mighty Fighty Shush Bugs, our bug-only run. So last time, we took on the last star base of Eevee, our fighting guru and wrestling aficionado. Managed to defeat her, actually kind of handedly. I was quite surprised with doing all right. Doing as well as we did. We did lose one life with Jason, but that's not the worst thing in the world. I will take one life. Compared to losing, you know, the entire team. And then we went and talked with Arven, finally finishing up the Titan quest run there. So we defeated him. His Mabostiff is doing great. And now we need to meet up with someone who's really good at hacking things, really good with computers. And then a champion level Pokemon user. I wonder who those two could be. But we need to reach out to both of them and get a team together. So that way we can go into Area Zero and go help out. What's their face? Professor Sada. There we go. Oh, that could be bad. Oh, yes, that's very bad. That is a very poor way to start this. But okay. Great. Awesome. Wonderful. I love it. I should have known better. Cool. So that's how we'll do that here. Lord. So, what's next? We have... I guess really two options left. Because we need to go... after the star team leader. The big boss, which was revealed to be Cassiopeia. Probably a surprise to nobody. And then we need to go take on the Elite Four. And probably what we need to do. I don't want to do it because of how long it's going to take. Is to go after a bunch of Terra Dens. And see if we can't get the, get some shards. To change him, change her to be a steel Terra type. Why is that problematic? Because we need 50 shards to do that. And the only real way to get them, hi Dragonite, is by going after Terra Dens. Which there's maybe, what, three at a given moment in the world? So it's gonna be kind of rough for us to do that. Alright, Venom, round two. Maybe this time not just get killed immediately. Because I forgot that Bruxious was a... is a fish. So, you know, has a water move. So that was three, I want to say, people here? Trying to, oh, hi. Lock six. Trying to find everyone. Oh, hello. Okay, well, good to know. Now time to switch out. That's fine. Yeah, we'll go with you. Trying to find everyone we need to fight here so we can get whatever the free item is from the league rep. Okay. Great. Okay. I think 4 was the number of trainers I need to beat, so we're probably good. Let's fight a couple Scyther real quick. Just to get some extra experience. It's fine. Actually, I could probably go after Lusprey too, come to think of it, because you're rock ground, so Luxray is probably just not going to be able to touch you. It's not a bad idea. Luxray's probably some decent experience. Huh? Coming for me? Oh, darn. Tried to sidestep. That's fine. Whatever. Is that speed? Yeah, that's fine. I'm fine going last. Don't need to go. Doesn't matter if you go first as long as you can survive and hit hard enough. Nice. Yeah, that was a very good experience. That was a good choice. No, don't come after me. I want to sneak up on you. Listen, I want to fight you, but I want to fight on my own terms. I want to cheat, is what I'm saying. So I want to come and sneak up behind you like that. And just get a free attack. And hopefully, it's high enough power that it just takes you out. Like that. That's what I want. Is it cheating? Slightly. But we do what we must. Oh, perfect. Vaughn's already evolving. Wonderful. So I also have an Arbeliva. That in mind, something that is most annoying is that this Arbeliva's sprite is quite large. So it's going to have a slightly different life structure, but that's fine.
Arbeliva, the olive Pokemon. This calm Pokemon is very compassionate. It will share its delicious, nutrient-rich oil with weekend Pokemon.
Cool. So it's a nice little support character. I love it. Good guy, Arbeliva. Awesome. Yeah. This is a very safe Pokemon to fight. Good. I need safe Pokemon to fight. I need to... Okay, as I thought. Good. Yay. We have the Tyranitar.
Tyranitar, the armor Pokemon. Extremely strong. It can change the landscape. It is so insolent that it does not care about others.
Wow, rude. Fine. Be the loner Pokemon. How much money do I have? We'll figure out here in a second. Let's get over to the Poke Center. Let's heal up. And get our free item. Let's figure out how much money we have, and then let's go get some vitamins for our new friends here. Okay, you. What are you going to give me? Yes, I have. Oh, I need 5. You're awful. Alright, let's go find a 5th person to fight real quick. So I'm assuming there's someone over here, maybe? That I haven't fought? Or not? So where is the last person? Fought that small child. Okay, is this gonna be north 2 still if I come up here? Dark Pulse. Seems like it. So, is there someone out here I can fight? I'd really love to. Someone? Anyone? Just want one little battle. Just one little trainer battle. There is the trainer battle person. But definitely not using Venom. Because you being a black belt, you probably have fighting Pokemon, which would be bad for my Dark Rock Tyranitar. Indeed. Because Venom has a dark move. So he should still be alright. We may still be alright. We should be alright. Yes, okay, good. Up that way. Do I have 5 yet? Yes, I do. Outrage, okay. 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 That could be good. Okay. So now let's head back to Mezagoza. Mezagoza's over here. And see about getting some vitamins. That one, I can't sell anything either, okay? So I could get one... I can get 2 if I buy it with a... Well, no, because it's 25 to get someone to max, so I can get 1 person up once. Or if I wanted to do mints, okay. You know, let's... I'm going to get 25... I'm going to at least get Vaughn there. I think that's worthwhile. So, Vaughn, have some medicine. There you go. So, how many things can I sell? And can I manage to get another 25 for somebody else? Probably not, but no. Well, maybe actually. How much is that going to give me? 78. So, no, not quite. Not even near. That's fine. Let's get at least Venom and Jason up to 60. The other two, I think, will get there in time with us going to train up here. This gives us plenty of time to go check out some of those Terra Dens. Steel, because I want to get a bunch of steel shards and then bugs to maybe get a couple more members of the team. All right, where is that Steel Den? Steel Den is out here. No. Stop that. Okay. Yeah, it should work. Realize I don't have a fighting move, so that's not great. And I shouldn't be, Okay, that's not great. So let's just go for it and hope for the best here. This could be bad. Kind of. It ain't great. Yeah, you know, I'm just gonna bug out. It's fine. Don't even worry about it. Not needed. Nope. We're not chancing that. Let's go check out some of the other bug dens that are around. And if I can get them, we might. It is going to require either a... I've not gotten one on the mountain, so I could, in fact, get this one. It's going to have to be a 3 or a 4 star. Because we are... fairly low. What do we got here? Nope. Not a 1 star. What is this bugged in? An Axu. That almost seems like cheating, though, so I'm not going to do that one. Am I going to regret this later? Maybe. It's possible. Because I don't have anything in North 3, do I? I do not. Cool. So this is still a valid one for me to go get. What do we have here? A Zangoose. That... is interesting. Okay, so hopefully the Zangoose won't be too much of an issue. Should be fine, I think. Especially since we have Daft Punk here with a Dragonair helping us out. We should be just fine. Oh, yes. We'll be fine. So that puts us at 9. Ten will get a Slitherwing. Yeah, 3 and 4 stars only. We'll kind of go from there.
Zangoose, the cat ferret Pokemon. It survives arch rival. To threaten those it encounters, it fans out the claws on his front paws.
Scary. Yes, we want to give him a nickname. Don't care that it's female. Its name is Big. Fly to. This is a place to fly to. And we're probably going to go over to that forest area. With the toad scrules and such. No, we don't. I was trying to figure out which one to do. I think Brick Rick will be fine. We can switch it for Thrash just because I don't... Yeah, we'll switch it for Thrash because I don't particularly like getting confused. Gray Fox, welcome. Yes, we got Vaughn on Sunday, our honorary bug. Haven't gotten too much use out of him yet because it was only a 3-star raid, which means that we only started at level 35, so we're trying to get them up to speed, but, okay, 39 now, but still still pretty far down, as it were. No, we actually don't need Leech Seed, we can just have Mega Drain. Though I did shove a bunch of vitamins down its throat, so that way it has basically the best special attack stat that it can. So, that's helpful. Also, a very well-programmed game and doesn't know how to focus. There you go. So yeah, we're doing a little bit of training here. I want to get people up to, like, low 60s for everyone. Before we go after the last person of the Starbase, I think. We have to go fight Cassiopeia. Who's definitely not the Eevee girl. Could never be the Eevee girl. Chopping down all these trees. Even though supposedly I'm breaking bricks. But that's fine. Because I just need experience. Curse you, Sturdy. I'm going to stop fighting Sitta Widow because you're sturdy. Beat up a deer instead. So I can probably just do this and win. Well, I can do that and win if I actually hit, but... Are there any more people out here? Or is it just going to be wild pokes? Oh, there's a mantis. I want the big mantis. Which for some reason isn't a bug. But that's fine. I know what I'm gonna do. I know what we're gonna do. We're gonna swoosh on over here real quick. And I think we are gonna, as much as I do love getting people some additional levels here, we're gonna switch people out, so, the people who are going to be doing the fighting are going to be the ones getting the experience. So, move things around a little bit. Okay. So since I know they're over here, let's go get rid of a bunch of miserable piles of experience. Where's our big fluffy fairy? Maybe. Well, don't make a liar out of me, game. Where am I Chansey? I want the big old walking piles of experience. Give me a bunch of sunflowers instead. I don't want sunflowers. There we go. There's everyone's favorite pink puffball. Deliver unto me all the experience, Chansey. All of it, I say. Sweet, sweet experience. Yeah, there we go. That was okay experience. Okay. Is there another Chansey here? Can there be another Chansey here? I want a Chansey. I want to beat up another miserable pile of experience. Doesn't look like it. Okay. Okay, now for real this time. Hey, look, it's Clive. He must also want to know who Cassiopeia is.
Sup, Bruno? Yep, that's my name. Actually, no. It's time for me to bring this little performance to an end. Allow me to reveal my true identity. Ha ha!
Oh, look. It was the director.
I do apologize for deceiving you with my disguise. In truth, the boy you know as Clive was none other than the director of the Naranja Academy. Mr. Clavel.
Yeah, I know.
What? But my disguise was perfect. Although, now that I think about it, I did neglect to keep up my youthful act on a few occasions. That must have been what gave me away. Regardless, there is still one more astonishing truth I must reveal to you. The true identity of Cassiopeia, the big boss of Team Star, was me all along.
Yep. 100%. Nah.
Honest to goodness. When you heard Cassiopeia over the phone, that was actually a pre-recorded voice. I pulled it off using, you know, one of those high-tech gizmos. Oh yes, it was very clever.
Yep.
So, Master Bruno, now you know that I'm the big boss. That means there is just one thing left to do. Face me in one final showdown to decide it all.
Okay. Alright, Oranguru.
I am Cassiopeia of Team Star. With this battle, I will finally bring Operation Starfall to an end!
Okay. You are 60, so this is a little scary. Because you're psychic, which means you can easily take out me as a fighting Pokemon, but I'm strong enough to take you out in one. Okay, that's good. That's good. I like that. Very good. Oh, now you can learn close combat. Okay. Sure. Why not? Who's next? Houndoom. Yeah, we can switch to... Ew, we don't really have anyone we can really switch to be safe. How do I want to do this? Bug fighting is not bad, actually. Yeah, let's keep it. Because I forgot, you're a dark type. Oh, Fire Blast can be bad. It's really bad. Okay. Well. Okay. Yeah, Venom. Let's do it. This could be bad. Because you need Terastalize. This is an important battle. So you need to be the bug. Hopefully you have enough health to withstand one. Actually, you're like 2 or 3 levels below. I might have just sentenced you to death. Not quite. That was lucky. That was very lucky. Abomasnow. Yes, we will switch immediately. Let's do Aria. Let's, we might be okay here for a little bit, so let's do some setup. So, let's do special defense. Because I think you're more of a special attacker. Okay. That's fine. It's physical and special moves. That's not as great, but that's fine. We will also do attack. Okay. And let's do a speed. Okay. Now we'll heal. And then hopefully sweep. Because I should be able to do... Actually, I should be able to do Leech Life. Didn't quite work as well as I wanted it to, but it worked enough. Okay, now let's finish you off with Leech Life. Just get all my health back. Nice and easy. Poltergeist? Nope, we can just leave it run. I am gonna go ahead and give a revive to Jason, though. I want Jason to get some of this experience. Oh, don't burn me. It's rude. Also, I love how all the rest of the kids here are just, like, chilling out, and they're just watching the director of their school fight another kid. Yeah, that's fine. Don't even worry about it. Nothing weird's going on here. Okay. That could be bad. So you're definitely faster. We'll see how bad this is. Okay. I am very happy that I use the X special defense. Perfect. Yes. Stay out. And let's full restore. Get you all the way back up. Yeah, it doesn't work as well, does it? Okay. Take that, Among Us. And then quick wobble. Heh, to think that I, Cassiopeia, would be backed into a corner like this. Throw in the towel, director. Alright, Liberace. Very well. It seems I shall have to terrestrialize my Pokemon. That's fine. Oh, that might not be fine, because you're going to turn into a water type, aren't you? Yes, you are. That's annoying. Okay, well. Don't have anything for water. Hopefully it won't matter.
Do take a step back, please. This may get dangerous.
How dangerous is this going to be? Oh, yeah, I'm a little more dangerous than I expected. Do I want to chance that? Kind of have to. Good, got it. Alright, and quote, Cassiopeia has been defeated.
How strong you have grown. Well now, Master Bruno, it seems you have grown quite splendidly over the course of your treasure hunt. And here, once again, I must apologize. I am not actually Cassiopeia.
Surprise, surprise.
Though Clive and myself being the same person was no lie, mind you, Cassiopeia's true identity remains hidden. But I believe I can hazard a guess as to who they might be. That is why I sought to spare you from having to confront them in battle. Their sorrows should not be yours to bear. However, Cassiopeia has settled on a course of action and is determined to see it through. I do not imagine an ordinary student could hope to stand against them and win. So I challenge you to a battle to test your skill. If you had lost, it would have fallen to me to bring down Cassiopeia. Such was my resolve. But it turns out you are as strong as you are kind. If anyone has a chance at saving that poor child, it is surely you. As an educator, it shames me to burden one of my students with such a task. But please, defeat Cassiopeia. Take on the big boss of Team Star and win.
You got it.
Thank you. From the bottom of my heart, I leave this in your hands.
You there, what do you think you're doing?
Ah, Miss Time, a pleasure to see you.
It's no pleasure at all, Mr. Calvell.
I come here to investigate reports of an illicit battle on school grounds, and what do I find? Why, the director of the academy himself, facing off against one of our students, no less. What were you thinking?
No, if I could just explain. You see, it is a rather sad tale.
Oh, spare me. Your excuses reek worse than a stunkie's behind.
A stunkie's behind? Remember, the big boss asked us to meet them in the schoolyard after dark. I'm counting on you, Master Bruno.
You'll write a letter of apology to the students and faculty at once. And I'll be reporting this to the chairwoman of the school board. Make no mistake.
Good gracious, no. Anything but that, I implore you.
Rip to the director. Okay, everyone got leveled up. Or not leveled up, but... yeah, you get my point. Okay, I guess... no, we're gonna have not Venom be front. We're gonna have Jason be front. Okay. So for real this time, let's go take out the boss of Team Star, who definitely isn't Cassiopeia. No, I'm not interested in any class. I want to go to the school grounds. Schoolyard, there we go.
Bruno. Thanks for coming. This must be quite a shock for you. The big boss, Cassiopeia, they were both me all along. When I saw you make quick work of those Team Star lackeys outside the school that time, the idea for Operation Starfall suddenly came to me. My skills let me get a hold of as much LP as I want, so I decided to use that to tempt you into helping me out. After the operation started, I kept an eye on you as a member of the supply unit, and I had you battle those bosses on my behalf. All for the goal of defeating me and putting an end to Team Star once and for all. But still, there's a part of me that wants Team Star to live on, and I just can't roll over and let you win without putting up a fight. This is the final showdown. Are you ready?
As I'll ever be.
Thanks.
Sorry to keep you. The letter of apology missed time had me... preparations took longer than expected.
That voice... Are you Clive?
Penny. So it was you after all. Is that you, Cassiopeia?
In the flesh. I have a task for you, Clive, if you'll accept it. I want you to record what happens next so I can send the video to Team Star. They need to see the outcome of this battle for themselves.
Okay, will do.
I wonder what Pokemon that Penny's gonna have. Then allow me to introduce myself properly. I'm the big boss of Team Star. The name's Cassiopeia. No, Penny. Now bow down before the overwhelming might of Team Star's founder.
Hopefully not. Hopefully I can just win. Oh, look. It's an Eevee team.
I won't hold back in this battle. I'll stay true to Team Star's code.
Time for some setup. Let's do defense. Lower attack. Bad. Okay. Let's do speed. Oh, that's dead, isn't it? No, it's not. Okay, good. And then let's get Umbreon out of here. I didn't realize that you had Psychic.
Oh, don't crit. Okay, that's good. No crits, no crits, no crits. I am faster, so I'm just going to go ahead and use the attack. Okay, good. Flareon, less good. Very much less good. But we'll keep it. So we are going to full restore and hope that we can survive. Don't have fire blast. Fire spin. Okay, that's not awful. That's still pretty awful, actually. Okay. Yeah. Oh, that's not the right move. Okay. The other problem is, though, is that... Well, no, because I didn't use close combat, so my stats aren't going to get lowered. Well, it's going to get lowered by that, but... I'll take that as opposed to just dying. Yeah, that's not good. But it doesn't do nearly as much damage, so this allows me to do some setup. So we'll dance around a little bit. Okay. That's fine. That won't kill me. Little potion back up. We're going to use another defense to hopefully stop from getting as much damage. That's fine. I think I'm back to being minus, but I'd rather be able to heal. So I'll set up all day long on this Flareon. Okay, so what am I at? Minus one special, minus two attack. Okay. Well, let's get that back up. Stop lowering my attack. Okay. Stop it. How are you faster than me still? Ah. Okay. Riveting combat, I know. But I'm not letting Jason die. Yeah, I'm already in the vortex. Okay. I'm not going to bother doing another speed. I just need to hit this Flareon and get it out of here. I need you to stop lowering my attack. I guess Baby Doll Eyes just always goes first, and that's why you're faster.
Okay. Get out of here, Flareon. Okay. Vaporeon, that should be fine. We'll just stick with it. I am not at all scared of you. Just more Mega Horn. Shouldn't. Nope, that kills him. Neat. There goes Jason. Making bad decisions all the way around. Okay. That's fine. I'll take the free kill on that one. Okay. Who's next? You have a Jolteon. That should be fine. So, now you get to have some setup. Some special defense. That has got to stop. Oh, woof. Okay. Okay, yeah, it's fine. Start hitting, please. Well, let's just get it done. Get Jolteon out of here. Good. Okay. Who's next? Leafeon. Perfect. More setup time. We can use the item. This is as good a time as any. Like, we already lost one member. Let's not use another. Not lose another. Let's just curse a little bit. That's fine. Just go ahead and okay, you need to stop using baby doll eyes. I forget that all of you Eevees have it. At this point, it's just attrition. All right, let's have this fight. How many am I down? I gotta be down, what, 3 at this point now? Just 2. Okay, well. Yeah, just keep going with it, I guess. At this point, you need to probably save at least 2, so that way. I can actually take out what I'm going to assume is Sylveon at the end here. Yeah, I guess let's curse. Keep cursing, lowering my speed, raising my attack. So nothing's going to be able to hurt me. But I apologize that this fight is kind of boring. Especially if you keep lowering my attack. Stop it. Am I still 2 down? I'm 1 down. Fine. I'll use my last X attack.
Now, Leafeon, gonna need you to stop this. We can't keep doing this. It's time for you to stop. Stop using baby doll eyes. You are legitimately the worst. There. Get out of here. Alright, who's your last one? Is it Sylveon, like I'm expecting? Yes, it is. Perfect.
I can't fault you on your battle skills at all. No wonder the bosses fell at your hands. Time to terrestrialize. Shine bright like the starry sky and become who you really want to be.
Oh, stop it. It's not going to matter by the time we're done here. You can lower my attack all you want, but if I'm still super effective and you still have much higher speed than I do, it ain't going to matter. Okay. We survived. Not without losing one, but we survived. Well, okay. Take that, Penny.
It's all over now. It's finally over, guys. It's done.
And one more flashback.
We're done here. I think we should call it quits.
Hold up. Are you saying we should break up the team? You gotta be joking.
We got carried away with Operation Star. Now everything's gotten out of hand.
Yeah, well, that's what happens when you round up a bunch of bullies in the courtyard and make a show of learning them some manners.
But we don't even have to fight him in the end. We didn't do anything wrong.
Indeed. Merely did we declare our intention to battle tooth and nail should the villains persist in their tyrannous oppression. 'Twas a bloodless victory, we assure you.
Yeah, and they didn't even send out their Pokemon. They just blubbered and apologized a whole lot. Our outfits must have spooked them good.
But the bullies made a huge stink about what went down. And then they all ended up leaving the academy. Our plan backfired epically. There's no way we're going off scot-free. We're getting off scot-free.
I guess you're right. This little stunt might have put us up a creek.
I'll fix this mess on my end. Just leave it to me.
What are you saying?
I'm the one who started Team Star. I dragged you all into this. So I'll take responsibility for everything.
Oh, noble and kind bug, big boss. You cannot...
Now that the bullies are gone, you guys should start going to school again.
Oh yeah? And what about you?
I can't go back.
But why? There's no reason for you to stay shut in your room anymore, right?
All I can say to you guys is, thanks. Even though we never met in person, you were all so kind to me.
Stop right there, BB. Why are you talking like we'll never speak again?
I need to go take care of some things.
Prithee, speak to us. What is thine intent?
Hey, big boss, answer us.
Bye-bye, guys. Thanks for everything.
Thanks for everything, Bruno. And you too, Clive.
I'm glad I got to see this through to the end.
I guess this is it for Team Star. And me, too.
Hold that thought, Miss... Penny. I'd like to check something with you first.
Check what?
Why resort to something like Operation Starfall if you're the big boss of Team Star? Wasn't there any other way to handle this?
I tried telling the bosses that we were done once before, but they still didn't quit.
Why not simply order them to?
Our code states that no one in the team has the right to order people around. I can ask them all to do stuff, but I can never order them.
So, it's back to the code once again. The bosses must have taken it very seriously.
They did, and that's why I know I could use it to force Team Star to disband.
Because the bosses would do anything the code required of them? Even leave the team?
Yes. And according to the code, they had to accept any challenge made to them.
Thus the idea for Operation Starfall. Cassiopeia, let me ask you one last thing. What does Team Star... No, what do your friends in the team mean to you?
They're my greatest treasure.
Splendid. Thank you for apprising me of the situation, Miss Penny.
What?
Now, young lady, there's something I should very much like to discuss with you.
Hey, quit it with the old geezer act, Clive. You're creeping me out.
Indeed. Well then, before we talk further, allow me to reveal to you my own secret identity. Hiya!
Director Clavel?
Just as Cassiopeia was your disguise, the boy you knew as Clive was mine.
But why?
I needed a way to talk to Team Star on equal terms. Students do tend to shy away from speaking their mind to teachers, after all. Much more so when faced with the director of the academy.
Yeah, but where do I even start? Wasn't the outfit a bit much? Plus, I have some big feelings about that wig.
Well, that's quite enough of that for now. Everyone, why don't you come out?
Huh?
Yo, big boss, long time no see.
Momo.
More like long time no meet, right? I mean, we only found out your real name just now. Melly.
Verily, is thy long hidden countenance a sight for sore eyes, my lady?
Atticus. So, I heard your real name's Penny. How have you been this whole time? Ordy.
We found you at last. You've had no idea how worried we've been. Airy.
I ain't crying if that's about what it's going to come to.
Hasta la vista, Cassiopeia, and hello, Penny.
I missed a line. It's fine. You all saw it.
Now then, Miss Penny, and each of you young bosses as well. On behalf of the Academy, I have something I would like to say to Team Star. You all have my sincerest apologies.
Come again?
As director of the Academy, I let you down. My handling of your situation was a dismal failure.
What? I still don't... Why?
You all told me about your reasons for forming Team Star and about your subsequent actions. Ever since my first days as director, all I've ever experienced of the Academy is an environment blessedly free from bullying. But now I know the peace was built on the backs of your hurt and anger, and of course, your immense courage in putting things to right. And so, I'll get straight to the conclusion. The Academy's order for Team Star to disband, and my threat to expel those who did not obey, are hereby revoked.
Does that mean what I think it means?
Indeed. Team Star can continue to exist, should that be your wish.
Woohoo! Penny, isn't this great? Now we can all stay together.
Oh, my heart is giddy with glee.
But
I betrayed all of you.
You mean Operation Starfall? Director Clavel told us all about it. Far as we heard, you only went through it to save us from getting expelled. You were just worried about us, right? Not like we'd ever chuck the team just because you told us to, after all. In our style.
I cannot even begin to imagine how you must have feared for us, Lady Penny.
Sorry for making you worry, BB. We're all okay now. But even so...
Hold on, everyone. I have more to say. As previously stated, the requirement for Team Star to disband has been revoked. However, there are still some unsettled matters to discuss. Allow me to provide a few examples. Your protracted truancy, your brazen customization of school uniforms, your unauthorized usage of academy equipment, your reckless modification and jeopardous driving of Pokemon-powered vehicles. Need I go on? Your flagrant disregard for the school rules cannot simply be overlooked. Thus, as punishment, you'll all be required to engage in community service.
Community service?
Yes. Specifically, I will be asking you to manage the STCs.
And that stands for?
The Star Training Centers. They shall be facilities for cultivating Pokemon trainers' talents. I plan for the Academy to found them in collaboration with the Pokemon League. The idea came to me when I saw Master Bruno battling his way through your bases. The base's construction, as well as the battle tactics employed by the students in Team Star, are remarkably unique and creative. I would ask that you continue your team activities, but henceforth as STC staff members, using your former bases as training facilities. And that is the sum of it. Does anyone have any concerns?
No, it sounds like fun, so I don't see how this can be anything but a win-win. This may be a weird thing to say since the STCs are supposed to be a punishment and all, but... You should totally join in too, Penny.
Tis true. We would most happily have you at our sides, my lady.
We can go to school together too. That way, if anything happens, we'll be there to protect you.
We were already talking about how great it'd be to have both Team Star and school in our lives. That'd be a sweet deal for us. So, what do you say?
You guys... Bruno, what do you think?
Thumbs up.
Huh? But just...
No need to give your response right this moment, Miss Penny. Do take some time to decide. For now, at least, I think our little group should go their separate ways. Not to say that you should break up Team Star, after all. I simply meant it is time to leave. Master Bruno, please stop by my office later, if you would.
Yay! We saved the world! And we do need to go to the director's office so we can actually finish this story beat. So let's do so.
There you are, Master Bruno. I want to thank you for all your hard work in resolving the situation with Team Star. If not for you, I suspect I would have done the team a grievous injustice in my choice of punishment for their actions. You have my sincerest gratitude. Who is it?
It's Penny.
Ah, Miss Penny, do come in.
Hello, Director. About the STCs, I'd like to work with them together with the rest of Team Star.
That's wonderful news. Thank you very much for your favorable response.
But, I should be punished more severely than the others, I think.
Why so? Because of Operation Starfall?
No, not that. Because of the other really bad thing I did.
And what would that be?
You know, the LP I gave you both in exchange for helping me with Operation Starfall? I got a hold of it sort of illegally by hacking the Pokemon League's LP management system.
Ah, I see. That is quite the revelation. I did not think such a thing was possible in the first place.
It wasn't all that hard. I mean, I'm really sorry and I won't do it again.
Nice save.
This matter is really out of my jurisdiction, I'm afraid. I will have to consult Miss Greta, the Pokemon League chairwoman, on how best to proceed.
I figured as much.
I do apologize, Master Bruno, but I will have to ask you to give us some privacy.
Okay. That was that it? I think we're still missing something, aren't we? No, we're not. Okay, fine. Well, all right. So unfortunately, Jason, you did good, my friend, but I misjudged. So you're also out. Okay, we don't have a lot of people left. I think before we go on to the Elite Four, we need to have a training day. So I think we are going to have to actually do a little more serious training. Get some of our other members here leveled up. And see about going into the final battle of the Elite Four, not quite as behind. In any case, that'll be all for this evening. Thank you so much for joining us once again in the final battle with Team Star and taking all of those players out. We'll be back next time on Sunday with probably a training day so we can get Vaughn and Venom and Big a little higher in levels, and maybe we can survive the Elite Four. We'll see. I'm not quite sure we will, but we'll see what happens. Until then, this is Bruno Fightmaster, signing off. Bye-bye!